is the anatomy of the ear. That means the internal section of the ear, what all things that are present inside the ear. So as you can see over here, the ear consists of mainly three regions. That is the outer ear, which is this part, right? And then you have the middle ear, which is this part. And then you have the inner ear, which is this part, right? This entire region is the inner ear, correct? And this part over here, this region over here, is the middle ear. Okay, and this performs the outer ear. Now, if you talk about the function of the ear, we know that it performs two important sensory functions. What are those? One that we know definitely is hearing. And second important function that it does is maintenance of body balance, right? So we will be seeing down the slides how, which part of the ear, in fact, which part of the ear is helping in the maintenance of this body balance, okay? Body balance and posture, right? So let's go on further. The external ear, that is the outer ear. So what is the function of this outer ear? It collects sounds. And what are the structures involved in the outer ear? They have the auricle, or it is also called as spina, right? It has this elastic cartilage that is covered with skin, okay? Now this spina is connected via the external auditory canal, okay? It is also called as meatus. So canal is also called as meatus. You can also say an external auditory meatus. Correct? Now this spina, what does it do? It collects all the vibrations from the air, and that helps in producing the sound. And these vibrations will now pass through this auditory canal, right? This is the auditory canal, as you can see here. Okay, this region. So from this pinna, the vibrations that are being collected is passing through this auditory canal, and it is going to reach the tympanic membrane or the eardrum. What is this tympanic membrane? It is the collagen. It is made up of the collagen and elastic fibers. Okay. And this eardrum, it's part of the middle ear. Okay. This eardrum actually forms the part of the middle ear. Right. And now in this eardrum, you know, there are tiny hairs that are present. Okay, and these hairs, they produce, so here you have hairs, okay, very fine hairs that are present, and these hairs, they produce these wax secreting sebaceous glands. Okay, so you have these sebaceous gland. There is another word for sebaceous glands, and that is also called as curcuminous glands. Okay, the sebaceous glands, right? So these glands, they secrete this wax, and this wax helps to moisten the eardrum, and it's kind of a protection for the eardrum. Even the pinna also secretes some amount of the wax. Okay, let's go to the next. Now, middle ear. Now, middle ear has these three ossicles. So, in addition to now to the eardrum, as you go deeper inside, the eardrum is directly attached to the ossicles. Okay, there are three ossicles. ossicles are nothing but the three small bones that are present. And what are these bones? Malleus. Okay, it's kind of hammer shaped, if you will see. Okay, it's hammer shaped. Then you have incist, which is anvil shaped. Okay, it's anvil shaped. So here you can see this part. So this is stirrup. Right. Now they are attached to each other, as you can see, in a chain like manner. Okay, and this tapes bone, you know, it goes on and it attaches to the oval window over here. Okay, you also have a round window over here that is below it. Okay, this oval window is actually entering into this inner ear region. Okay, this is the inner ear. Okay, this is the inner ear region. Okay, so this oval window, it is entering the inner ear region. So the middle ear is thereby connected to the inner ear via this stapes, which goes right inside the inner ear, that is the cochlear region, which we'll see. Okay, now to this middle ear, you have also one more thing, that is the auditory tube. You can see here, this is the auditory tube. Now this auditory tube is also called as eustachian tube. Okay, IAN, eustachian tube. This eustachian tube, what does it do? It connects the middle ear region. Okay, it connects this middle ear region to the pharynx region, that is the throat region. Okay, I can say the pharynx region or the throat region. Clear? So what does this auditory tube or the eustachian tube does? It is connecting the middle ear to the eustachian tube. So that is the connection. But what is the function of this eustachian tube? It helps in equalizing the pressures, you know, on both the sides of the eardrum. You can see this is the eardrum over here, correct? And there is the pressure which is going to come from here, and there is this pressure which is going to come from here also. So it helps in maintaining the pressure on both the sides of the eardrum. Because if you know one of the sides the pressure is more, then there could be effect on the eardrum. Now what is the role of these three ossicles that we had discussed? Malleus, incus and stapes. Okay, stapedus, or I can just simply say stapes. Okay, so what is the role of these three small bones? The role of these three small bones is to maintain the, or increase the, in fact, the efficiency of the transmission of sound waves. Okay, so in short, whenever these vibrations are coming from the, collected by the pinna, it is received by the eardrum, and these vibrations, when it passes on to the ossicles, they are going to get amplified. Just like you have a speaker, when you attach it to any of your device, the sound from the device gets amplified. So the same way over here, the vibrations gets amplified with the help of these three small bones. Okay, and these tapes, or it is the muscle, actually name is stapedus muscle. Then muscle name is stapedus muscle. they are the smallest. Even the bone is the smallest. Stapes is the name of the bone, and it is the smallest bone, and stapedius muscle is the smallest muscle in the body. Right? And if you know what are the frequencies that man can hear, man can hear as low as 20 hertz frequency and as high as 20,000 hertz. Right? We'll say it is kilohertz, it is not so let me write it like this, 20,000 hertz. Okay, so this is the minimum range and this is the maximum range that a man can hear. Next, we move on to the inner ear. It is also called as labyrinth. Okay, it is also called as labyrinth. Now, it is this bony labyrinth, you can say, and it is also having a membranous labyrinth. Okay, you can see there is this bony labyrinth and you also have a membranous labyrinth. Okay, what does it do? It basically helps in communicating, okay, between the chambers and tubes. So, these bony labyrinth is a set of tube-like cavities in the temporal bone. And it consists of these semicircular canals. You can see here, there are three semicircular canals. One that is going right here. Another that is going right here. Okay, and then another you have is over here. Okay, so you have these three semicircular canals. You also have a vestibule region over here, and you have this curved spiral shape that is going around is the cochlea. Okay, it is lined with peristonium and filled with perilymph. This perilymph, you know, it is just very much similar to the cerebrospinal fluid. You all have heard when we talked in the central nervous system, right? So it is very much similar in nature to the cerebrospinal fluid. Right? And this membranous labyrinth, you know, it is filled with endolymph. The membranous labyrinth is filled with endolymph. Okay, here you can see clearly the bony labyrinth. The bony labyrinth, which contains perilymph, and you have the membranous labyrinth, which contains the endolymph. So we have gone zoomed in and we have gone right inside this. Okay, and at the base of these semicircular canals, you can see that there is this ampulla. Okay, so the base of this canal is swollen. Okay, you can see clearly that it is swollen. Okay, and it also contains this projecting ridge, which is called as crista ampullaris. Okay, and that has less hair, that has also hair cells. Now, this vestibule, you can see it consists of utricle and saccule. Okay, utricle and saccule, they form the vestibule apparatus. Okay, you also have ampulla, we have discussed. Let's move on to the next slide. Okay, so here we come to the cochlear region. So here you have this tubular structures of cochlear region. A lot of things that are present inside the cochlear region. Okay, so you have this resonas and the basilar, okay, which is dividing the surrounding perilymph. Okay, you can see over here, this is the basilar membrane which is there. Okay, and this basilar membrane is actually dividing the perilymph, you know, surrounding perilymph. And it is dividing it into upper scalar vestibuli, Okay, you have this upper scala vestibuli. Okay, and you have lower scala tympani. Okay, so this one is upper. You can see it is above the basilar membrane, and this one is lower. It is below the basilar membrane, right? Okay, and the space within the cochlea is called as the scala media. Okay, so the empty spaces that are there between inside the cochlea region, that is the scala media. Right. So it is in within the membranes. Okay, that is also filled with endolymph. And now at the base of the cochlea, you will see that this scala vestibuli, it ends at the oval window. Scala vestibuli, can you see that? Okay, it ends at this oval window from the stapes, yeah, stapes which is coming. So this is the region of the cochlea which is getting directly connected to the stapes. Right, and you have the scala tympani, which is terminating at the round window. Here you can see the round window. So here you have the scala tympani, which is coming in the round window. Okay, and this is going to open up into the middle ear. Next, coming to the organ of Corti. Okay, this is the organ of Corti. Now, this organ of Corti is located at the basilar membrane. Okay, so the whole yellow thing that you see is the basilar membrane, but at the basilar membrane, at some point, at one particular point of this membrane, you have this organ of Corti. Okay, this organ of Corti, they have hair cells. Okay, what do they have? They have hair cells, which is present in row. Okay, in rows, these hair cells are present. Okay, and they act as the auditory receptors. So they act as auditory receptors. The basal end of this hair cell, you know, they are in close contact with the afferent nerve fibers. See, of course, you will have the nerves being linked to this ears, because it has to again reach to the our nervous system, right? There has to be communication. So from the vestibule, you will have the vestibular nerves coming out. From the cochlear region, you will have the cochlear nerves coming out. Okay. So you have the nerve fibers, which is coming out from this basal end of the hair cell. That means the last part, the end part of the hair cell. Okay, and then you have a large number of processes, you know, that they are also called as stereocilia. They are projected from the apical part. So you have this hair cell. Okay, so from the basal region, I told you what comes out, the afferent nerve fibers comes out. Sorry, the afferent nerve fiber comes out, and from the apical end, what is there? Is the stereocilia. Okay, I'll show you the picture in the following slides. Where is stereocilia? So stereocilia is from the apical end of the hair cell, and above this rows of hair cell, you know, you will have the rows of hair cell, and above this hair cells, you will have a membrane which is called as stectorial membrane. So where are all these which I'm talking about? It is present in the organ of Corti. Okay, so let's see the pictures. ear. So can you see the tectorial membrane now? And you have the basilar membrane, and above the basilar membrane you have the spiral organ, which is called as the organ of Corti. Yes. So you have the cochlear duct, which is containing endolymph. Okay. Yeah. We have zoomed in, gone deep into the organ of Corti, and see where are the stereocilia. Oh, yes, I can see. Stereocilia over here. So the apical end, that's the hair bundles. Okay. And below it, you have the supporting cells. And then you have the tectorial membrane. So you see how many hair cells are there? There are 16,000 hair cells, and they have 30 to 100 stereocilia. That means small microvilli like projections. Okay, and they come in contact with this tectorial membrane. Okay, which is, what is a tectorial membrane? It is a gelatinous membrane. Okay, that overlaps with the spiral organ of Corti, right? And the basal sides of the inner hair cells, they have the nerve fibers, as I told you. So they will synapse with the first order sensory neurons, whose cell body is in spiral ganglion. Okay, next we go to the vestibule region of the inner ear. These semicircular canals, you can see that they are placed at right angles to each other. The membranous canals, they are suspended in these perilymp of the bony canals. So we have talked about the ampulla. It has this ridge which is called as crista ampullaris. Okay, this has a ridge, okay, which is called as crista ampullaris, okay, and they also have the hair cells. Okay, now this saculand or utricle, these two, they also have a ridge that is called as macula. Okay, so these two also have a ridge which is called as macula. So this crista and macula, okay, they together are responsible for the maintenance of balance of body. Okay, so you have the balance of body and posture. So who is responsible for this? Crista and macula. So they are the specific receptors of this vestibule apparatus. Okay, so what are these two? These two are the specific receptors. Okay, we now move on to the near the end part of it. Now let's zoom in into the saccule and the utricle. There are thickened regions which is called macula, which I just told you, and there are cell types. Which cells are there? You have again the hair cells with the stereocilia, right? And now these they have this gelatinous otolithic membrane. Okay, so this vestibular apparatus is having those three semicircular canals which we just saw, and this saccule and utricle, okay, together they are called as otolith organs. Okay, otolithic organs, or I can simply say as otolith organs. Okay, so saccule and utricle together, they are called as otolith organs. Fine. Now this otolith organs, they have this membrane, which is otolithic membrane, and they contain this calcium carbonate crystals, which are called as otoliths. Okay, and they move when you tip your head. Okay, so let's look at the pictures. Actually, you can clearly see over here otoliths, where are they present, and this is the otolith membrane. Okay, here. So when you move your head, you see that these cells which are there, they move, right? So they also bend in those direction, and you can zoom in and see how these otoliths look in. They look the crystals of the calcium carbonate. So with this, we now move on to the physiology of urine. So how the waves transfer from one part of the ear to another part of the ear. Okay, let's look at that, and then we end. So the auricle, that is the pinna, collects the sound waves. The eardrums will reach the eardrums, it vibrates, and these vibrations are amplified by the ossicles and the stapes, which is connected to the oval window. It will produce the fluid pressure waves in scala vestibuli and tympani. Okay, see, the oval window vibration is 20 times more vigorous than eardrum. Okay, you can see how much is the amplified vibrations that has been done. Okay, and these pressure fluctuations inside the cochlear duct will move the hair cells against the tectorial membrane. Okay, and then the microvilli are bent, producing receptor potentials. So you can see the movements of the basilar membrane. Okay, they will bend the hair cells and press them against the tectorial movement. You can follow the numbers. And the nerves and pulses are generated, that is the potentials that are developed. Okay, and they will be passed on through the afferent neurons via the afferent fibers, that is the auditory nerves, to the auditory cortex of the brain, where the impulses are going to get analyzed and the sound is recognized.